हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज का हमारा टॉपिक है अल्फा पार्टिकल स्कैटरिंग एंड रदरफोर्ड्स न्यूक्लियर मॉडल ऑफ एटम। सो बेसिकली यहाँ पर हम लोग स्टार्टिंग करेंगे इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम से। सो हियर दिस इज द सोर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम। ओके, सो इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम जस्ट पासिंग थ्रू इन दिस डायरेक्शन। वी हैव लेड ब्रिक्स। Why we use this lead bricks? To transform this electron in particular line form. So we get very focused electron beam. That's why we use this lead bricks. Right? Okay. Then after traveling through this in the gap between these lead bricks, we have one gold foil which is situated between two stands. So this is our gold foil, just like aluminum foil we have for the to preserve the food, right? So here we use gold foil. Okay, now what happens basically, here I am putting one traveling microscope which can rotate throughout this surface up to like this curved surface, right? So this traveling microscope can rotate from any surface, and the material we use to use in this detector, because this is called detector, right? So detector, which is made up of ZNS screen. Why we use here zinc sulfide? Because whenever electrons emits on this surface, it will glow. So that's why we can see that electrons are emitted on this surface. We can detect that electron, right? So we use ZNS screen for the detection of electrons, right? Okay. So many electrons are just passing through the gold foil and they are transmitting through the surface. But some electrons are changing their direction, and some electrons move back from which they are emitting on the surface, right? So if we denote that angle by theta, so this angle is also theta, right? This angle is also theta. So there are many angles because we use here traveling detector. So detector can travel anywhere, and we can find at what position we get the most of electrons get scattered on the surface, right? So basically, if we are talking about the working of this experiment, we use one source of electron beam. So what is the source of electron beam? Source is radioactive element. So we use here radioactive element to emit the electron beam. This radioactive element who emits beta particles, because beta particles is the source of electrons, right? So electrons is just passing through and it's just passing through line focused like laser beam by these lead bricks. After striking on the surface of gold foil, it may get scattered or it may get transmitted through this gold foil. So we can detect by this ZNS detector, which is whenever electron is just striking on the surface, the electron will glow due to this ZNS screen, right? So that's why we can find theta angle for as many electrons as possible. So why theta is changing for this scattered electron? Because gold foil is made up of Au and its atomic number is 79, which is very big. So its nucleus is also bigger, right? So whenever this electron is just getting head-on collision with the nucleus of gold, it will reflect it back, and that reflection angle will be 180 degree, because the path is same for emitting and it is same as for reflecting. So only one of 8,000 electrons comes in the same path which we they get emitted, right? So they get reflected here. Many electrons are scattered in this direction and many electrons are also in this direction. So there will be 10 raised to 3 for theta is equal to, yes, what is the angle here? Theta is equal to 150 degree and here for theta is equal to 180 degree. Same path, right? So one of 8,000 and here 10 raised to 3 for theta is equal to 150 degree. Right, so why this happens? Basically because we have nucleus is a very rigid sphere. That's why whenever electron gets head-on collision on that nucleus, it will reflected back. But what happens for the electrons which are transmitted out from this gold foil? So that electron never gets scattered because nucleus is only at the center, but all the other parts of our molecules are very empty. So electrons gets may directly transmitted through the space, so there is nothing will happen for that electron, so it will moving easily from these surfaces of the molecules of gold, right? So that's the complete theory of our experiment. So that's it for today. Now thank you very much. Please like and subscribe.